does it mean is, I'm not talking negatively about multitasking. I'm talking very positively about it. It means only that my brain or my mind becomes so fine that it is able to touch every thought at such a fast speed that I am able to do 4 to 5 things apparently at the same time. But for that, my fineness of mind has to be so sharp that I should be touching it in fractions of second, very fast. The other person will think, "Arey, he is doing so many things in 1 minute." But in that 1 minute, I have 60 seconds. I have still more lesser fractions of it, where I am doing tuk, 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 so fast. So, to do all these things, what do they say is, first, to attain any task in my life, where does stress comes? See this word. They are saying, for whatever to be achieved, first the person has to have Shraddha, Virya, Smriti and Samadhi Prajna. These are the 4 things that are essential for any person to achieve success in any particular field. Here they have put it down for yoga, but we can correlate it with any task of our life. So for that, first of all, whatever task we take in life, whatever we have taken up, okay, I have to put down this project, or I have to do something, I have to pass this exam, I have to be a good this yoga performer, or something, whatever the task I have taken. First, I have to have firm faith that yes, this can happen. I have to be strong upon that. If I am dicey that, oh, it may happen or may not happen, you may have seen many, we see, human, they say, humans are the best laboratories, moving laboratories. If we can communicate to most of the people, we are able to experience what they are experiencing. And then we are able to make our life more finer, even others' experiences. We need not experience everything. So, we have seen people like, they will take up something. Okay, I have decided to give my CAT entrance this time. But I don't know that they may take me at the IIM, or I don't know. If they don't take me at the IIM, then what should I do? So type of a dicey situation. But at the same time, we see other people who are very firm that, yes, I'll be at IIM Ahmedabad only. They are so sure about their thing that whatever happens later is a different thing. But before that task being performed, they are so firm about it, they have faith, firm faith. Or there is another class of people who have firm faith in what? Either their guru, either their God, whoever they have taken up as a support to themselves. And they are so strong that yes, my God will make me do all the right things and He will take me to the right place. So, wherever you have this Shraddha, it is so fine if you can understand. If I had not believed my teacher saying that this is S, this is T, this is R. This is first belief, primary belief. That yes, that teacher is saying that this is A, so I am saying this is A. If I decide that I don't want to believe the teacher right from my childhood, I will see that A is B only. The whole life, everything will be bullshit. So somewhere, that's why we started with Guru Brahma today. Guru Purnima has happened just on this Sunday. So Shraddha is very important. Whatever I take up, I have to have that firm faith. Then I have to have vigor and energy. So if we reverse this, if I don't have Shraddha, then that becomes a stressor. That becomes a stress situation for me. That I am not believing on either on myself or any of the superpower, my guru or whoever, some guide or some mentor. If I am not believing anyone, then it is all haywire. So everything is floating. Second comes my virya, that my vigor, my energy, that I will accomplish this task. I am sure, I am damn sure that I will do this. So that energy and enthusiasm to bring forward that particular thing, that I believe that this has to happen. So for that I will put whole of my heart and efforts. So this comes in virya. Here also, if I fumble somewhere, that I am not that okay. I have belief that yes, my God will do everything good for me. But if I am lying in my bed, then that God has to do everything for me only. So again, see, terms are ancient, but if you relate, everything is going to happen. So if the virya is my vigor and energy, I have to continuously have that. Then comes smriti, memory. That's my reminder that I have decided to reach this goal. He has stated in terms of yoga that I have to attain samadhi. We can take it in our own daily life that I have to attain a particular thing. So I have to have a daily reminder of it. Daily reminder should be there that yes, I have to achieve this. I have to achieve this. Sometimes in some of the stress management things, programs you might have seen, that I have to write my goals and read them daily. If you have attended some of the sessions, this is what is told everywhere. I am not talking something different. So, it is my memory, my reminder, which gives me alarm every day that I have to attain this particular thing. So, what we do in yoga? Teacher, what we do in yoga? Why we do it every day regularly? No. Still more ahead. It is a psychofeedback. It is a feedback to my brain that I have to achieve a particular thing. So even if on the first day, if my student is not able to raise, go up to directly Shirshasana, if he is looking at Shirshasana being performed by someone else, or he starts doing some Uttan Padasana, little single leg raising, double leg raising, he starts lifting. So as he does it regularly, there is a constant feedback that goes to the brain. Every day at morning, 6 o'clock, I have to do yoga for say half an hour I am doing. And in that, I have to reach this. Maybe I am not reaching it on the first day. But when that reminder goes in, that body, psychology and physiology, psychosoma, that connection makes it happen over a period of time. Automatically it will happen. So what we tell our students is, even if you are not able to do it for extensively, say, one and a half hour, or 2 hours, or 3 hours, daily if you are not able to practice, not a matter. One fine day if you say that there is a lot of work or some other point of time that there is no time. So, just remember that practices. Even some teachers say that, just do that exercises mentally. Even if you are just sitting in the train, traveling, you just perform that mentally. To that extent people are telling. What we can say in other ways is, at least do some reminder exercises. Say, if you are doing regularly for 1.5 hours, do it at least for 25 minutes, 30 minutes. But that reminder has to go. So that reminder brings me to my goal. So it will manage everything inside. Automatically the instructions will go to all my nerves, muscles and everything. That, yes, even if today I am not able to do it, tomorrow I have to reach it. So I have 24 hours. The mind works on my body that within this 24 hours, I have to reach this goal. Here it comes. How much is my faith in that? How much is my vigor in that? You must have seen many students, very enthusiastic. They become so enthusiastic that they are more enthusiastic even than the teacher at times. And for some, we have to knock them, we have to give them missed calls, then they will get up and then they will do. This is how we come across, means these are types of people. It is not only related to yoga. You can take it in any aspect of life. So, basically I have to have firm faith, then I have to have vigor and energy, then I have to have a constant reminder. I have to be regular in that practice, whatever I am doing. See, again, if we relate it with any other stress factor that is in our life, that will I pass my exam? If I just keep on thinking, that will I pass my exam, will I pass my exam? It will not happen. I have to have firm faith, I have to make efforts, and that efforts must be continuous. That continuous effort will surely make me pass through. And then is the Samadhi Prajna. Here I was not able to put it completely. Samadhi Prajna is, I have to have